Hello, hi my dear friends, welcome to my channel HSR Bioinfo. In previous class we have discussed the how absorption takes place in the microvilli of the small intestine. In this class we are going to discuss an important topic, that is the mechanism which involved in the absorption of the digested food substances. Let us start. Before going into the topic, we have to know some fundamental aspects regarding to the transport system which are present in the any cell of the human beings. So let us start with the background or fundamentals. Background, especially transport system. Transport system of any cell, whatever the cell in our body, that should contains the transport system. Transport system, which is essential for the transportation of the macromolecules or large particles and ions, minerals, digested food and etc. Let us see what are the classification which are present in the transport system. Actually, transport system simply which is divided into the two types. Type 1 is a passive transport and type 2 is a active transport. Active transport. Again, passive transport divided into the four types, that is simple diffusion, second one is a facilitated diffusion, third one is a osmosis, fourth one is a filtration. What it divided into? Four types: simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis and filtration. Coming to the active transport, again active transport divided into the two types. One is the primary active transport, second one is the secondary active transport. Again, primary active transport divided into the two types. Primary active transport divided into two types, that is the uniport and co-transport. Whereas secondary active transport again also divided into the two types. One is the symport, second one is the antiport. Okay, it is clear. All these are the transport systems of the any animal cells which are present in the human beings. Let us see what is the simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis and filtration, and also uniport, co-transport, symport and antiport. Okay, before going to this explanation, we have to see some important points regarding to the passive transport. Okay, and also active transport. Passive transport occurred without utilizing energy. There is no need of energy for the transportation of the any molecules using the passive transport. Whereas active transport which utilizes the energy, especially in the form of ATP. Here, passive diffusion utilizes the some integral proteins which are present in the transmembrane. Those include the carriers and channels. Whereas active transport utilizes the integral proteins, they are pumps and carriers. So these are the main important differences in between the passive transport and active transport. Okay, it is clear. Let us see how each and every aspect in this two passive transport and active transport will occur and how they will transport the moieties or any substances from the one side of the plasma membrane into the another side. Okay. You just assume this is the plasma membrane. Plasma membrane. Actually, we know very well plasma membrane that contains the lipid bilayer. So, this is the one layer and this is the one layer. Two layers, because of the presence of two layers, it is called as a bilayer, which is made up of lipids and proteins. Lipids and proteins. That's why it is called as a lipoprotein lipid bilayer. Most probably lipids are rich in the plasma membrane. That's why called as a lipid bilayer. Okay, let us see how simple diffusion is takes place. Actually, we have to note one thing here. Concentration gradient. Concentration gradient. Concentration gradient, it means higher concentration. It means, for example, if you take, this is the one part, this part actually contains the side 1 and side 2. It contains the two sides. Whereas, see, here is the many number of substances are present. Whereas, the side 2 that contains the similar substances very low. It means higher concentration here and lower concentration here. Whereas, substances from the side 1 to the side 2, if they transport, that is called as a concentration gradient, according to the concentration gradient. Whereas, substances that transport from the lower concentration to the higher concentration, that is called as a opposite to the concentration gradient. Okay, this is also a very important concept. If the substances from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, that transport is called as the according to the concentration gradient. Whereas, if the substances from the lower concentration to the higher concentration, such type of transport is called as opposite to the concentration gradient. Is it clear? So, see here, simple diffusion. In the simple diffusion, substances from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. Higher concentration through the lower concentration between the plasma membrane. Between the plasma membrane, here no need of energy. And also no need of any carrier and channel. No need of any carrier and channel proteins. That is called as a simple diffusion. Coming to the facilitated diffusion. Facilitated diffusion, which utilizes the carrier proteins.
are channel proteins.
Carrier proteins are channel proteins for the transportation of the substances from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. It means according to the concentration gradient. This is the integral protein which are present in the plasma membrane, that is called as a carrier or channel protein. So through these facilitated diffusion, large particles are the transported. Large particles are transported. Okay, coming to the osmosis. Osmosis actually takes place for the water. For the water, actually water is balanced in between the inner side of the plasma membrane and outer side of the plasma membrane. This osmosis occurred up to the neutralization. Here also higher concentration to the lower concentration, it will takes up to the similar concentrations which will occur at the both sides of the plasma membrane. That is called as a osmosis. Whereas coming to the filtration. Filtration is a process where solid particles that are separated from the liquid particles. Solid particles that are separated from the liquid particle, liquid, that is called as a filtration. Actually, this type of transport we can see in the kidney filtration. Kidney filtration. Okay, this is all about the simple diffusion, facilitated diffusion, osmosis and filtration. Okay, so coming to the active transport. Actually, it utilizes the energy pumps and carriers. Let us see what is the uniport and what is the co-transport. This is the uniport. It utilizes the actually pump. Pump is the protein which is present in the plasma membrane. That's why it is called as an integral protein of the plasma membrane. So here uniport is a condition where these pump transport only single substances from the lower concentration. This is must be important. Lower concentration to the higher concentration. In all the passive transport, they transport from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. But in the active transport, lower concentration to the higher concentration. Especially in the primary active transport, uniport that transport the substances, single substance from the lower concentration to the higher concentration by utilizing the energy ATP. ATP that converted into the ADP. ATP that converted into the ADP. Okay, coming to the co-transport. Co-transport also utilizes the pump, but here it transports two substances, but in opposite direction. Here the lower concentration to the higher concentration. Here also the concentration from the lower to the higher. Here also lower to the higher. In both directions they utilizes the energy that is called as a ATP, adenosine triphosphate, that converted into the ADP, adenosine diphosphate. Okay, coming to the secondary active transport. The difference between the primary active transport, secondary active transport is, this secondary active transport does not takes the ATP as energy resource. This is very important. ATP as energy
resources.
So it doesn't take the ATP as energy resources as like primary active transport, but it utilizes the carriers as a integral membrane proteins. How it will take place? First of all, you can see the SymPort. SymPort utilizes the carrier protein. Here, SymPort that transport the two substances, in the same direction, but the substances 1, 2, substances 1, 1 from the lower concentration to the higher concentration, whereas the substance 2 is a higher concentration to the lower concentration, which is called as a secondary active transport, is simply SymPort. SymPort means they transport two substances in the same direction, but concentration is a differ. One substance is from lower to the higher, another substance from higher to the lower. That is called as a SymPort. Coming to the final one, antiport. Here, antiport that transport two compounds, but the transport movement is opposite to each other. Let us see, this is a compound or substance 1, this is a substance 2. The movement you can see from here to here, whereas this compound move against to the this compound. So compound 1 move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration. Compound 2, that is from the higher concentration to the lower concentration. But these two, that is SymPort and antiport, they doesn't use the any energy resources for the transportation of the substances. In this way, all the transport mechanisms which are present in the any human cell. Okay, it is clear. Okay, if you understood this concept, then only you will understand the concept that is the absorption mechanism of the digested food substances in the microvilli of the small intestine.